In this one, we're going to look at this gas valve. This gas valve was a White Rodgers 36J27-508. What is different about this valve over a lot of others is this is a variable firing rate valve. Now, we've got a single firing rate, we've got double firing rate valves that are common, and this one is just simply one that is continuously variable from, I think, 35% to 100%. This certainly isn't a new valve. They've been around for quite a while, but the interesting part of it is that it actually does have a variable firing rate, and we're going to figure out what the firing rate, how the firing rate thing works on this, and what makes this valve tick. Okay, looking at this valve, it looks an awful lot like the Gemini valve. This is a Gemini here. It's a 36G22. And, you know, there's a lot of similarities between these two valves. Obviously, the variable firing rate is larger. Their main regulator, which is right here, is pretty much the same. The Gemini has an adjustment right here, and that's for adjusting manifold pressure. This one also has an adjustment right here, but it's only good for about 15%. You can set this, it's set at the factory, but you can change it 15% plus or minus. Another way of looking at these valves, they both have a solenoid, and they both have on-off switches, all the same there. What the difference is, you can see where here you've got the manual adjust for pressure regulation. It looks like there's something under here. So let's take a look inside this variable firing rate valve and see what's going on in there. Now here, with this covers taken off, they kind of look the same here too. Obviously, this is a little bit larger physically. We have the valve here for the regulator and the valve here for the regulator. So that part of it is, yeah, fairly similar. Let's take a look at the other side of these things. Both these valves essentially have the same regulator mechanism with these covers on. So that's pretty much the same. Now, this is where these valves are going to depart, because this has the manual manifold pressure setting, and this automatic pressure setting is under this black thing. And we're going to take a look at that next. Now, both of these valves, the regulators, are pilot regulated. That means there's a pilot valve that operates the main regulator. This video is not about how these regulators work, so I'm not going to go any farther on that. Maybe I'll link a regulator video to this. But suffice it to say, we are taking a pilot gas and we are changing that pilot gas pressure to increase or decrease the manifold pressure. Okay, with this top taken off, you can see here we have something going on here, and it's actually in just about the same place as the Gemini valve. And so our adjustment on this valve is right here. Now here, I have this piece turned upside down, and there's a little doohickey there. Now here's a diaphragm. The diaphragm goes right in there like that. And this is actually the valve here. So what's going on here? To get an idea of this, this diaphragm fits in here like that, and this piece fits over the top of it. And here's the other part of this. This is a little motor, and this thing rotates around. Okay, if you can see this, this actually goes on like that, and as the motor rotates, this little doohickey moves back and forth. So all it's doing when it's moving back and forth is it's adjusting this pilot regulator. It's the same thing as on the Gemini valve. It is just operated by a little electric motor. So, when I feed power into this thing, depending on what the voltage of the power is, this thing will rotate a certain distance. Now there's electronics inside here. I'll take that apart and we'll take a kind of a quick look at that. But what's actually happening here is when this motor turns, this thing moves up and down. And when it moves up and down, it moves the regulator inside here. Extremely simple in its actuation. Not much to this. Now the actual operation of it is kind of a different ball game. Okay, here's the electronics on it. Here's the motor. This is the solenoid for the redundant shutoff, your manual switch. We have inputs coming in here. We've got 24 volt inputs. These are AC inputs. We have a rectifier here. And I haven't looked over this thing really close, but it's probably powering this redundant solenoid coil. So, and we've got a little processor right here, and it's taking a pulse width modulation voltage anywhere from 3/100ths of a volt to, I think it's 5 volts, or pretty close to it, from the integrated furnace control to tell this motor how far to turn. Now, I'll try to set this up so it's operable with a pulse width modulation circuit. Not going to do that for this video, but just to give you an idea, this is a very simple operation. Again, this motor rotates and this moves up and down. This actually stays steady. And as the motor turns, this thing moves up and down. And that's the adjustment for the regulator on this unit. So it's actually very simple. With that thing just moving up and down, it's changing the pressure on the pilot for the regulator, just like it is done in this one manually. And it changes the manifold pressure. Not much to it. Pretty simple, kind of interesting. I will try to take this a little farther. Like I said, I'll see if I can set up a PWM to get this thing to move. We'll see if it does. Anyway, that's it on this one. Modulating gas valve.